Hello and welcome back to ExcelSIF. As promised in my last video, which was about transferring client data from the master sheet to the client's respective sheet automatically using advanced filters, macro and a bit of VBA. If you still haven't watched that video, here is the link on the top right and you can also find it in the description of this video. This time, I'm going to show you a method to achieve the same result but with pivot table and no macros. You notice that I didn't said no VBA. Don't worry, again, it's a very little VBA coding, which I'm sure you can handle easily. And cherry on top, this method is easier than before and also a bit quicker because neither do we have to create macros for all the sheets, nor we have to insert code on all the sheets. So let me show you what we intend to achieve in this video. We are going to create a sheet using pivot table and a bit of VBA, where whenever you add a record in this sheet, it gets updated in the client sheet as well. Now let's see how can we make such a system. We start with the same sheet as before, only this time I have added rate, amount, tax at the rate of 4% and the total amount. The reason I added all these is since we are going to use the pivot table method, which gives us a total at the end by default, it'll be good to have the total of quantities, amount, etc. We didn't have this information in our advanced filter method. Also, my data here is in a table because I want our client sheets to update whenever new data is added to our master sheet. So let's begin by creating a pivot table. Let's go to the Insert tab, click on Pivot Table and choose to create it on a new sheet. About the fields here, we want this table to look exactly like a master sheet. So, we have our tables here, as they appear in our master sheet, so we start by dragging them. All the numerical fields such as rate, amount, tax and total go to the values box and the remaining to the rows box. Let's do it the faster way by checking them all for now. Well, this doesn't look like a master sheet. For starters, we don't have an invoice number, our dates are grouped in months and where are the company's name? Don't worry. Excel, in its wisdom, has assigned the fields to value and row box. And since invoice number is a numerical field in our sheet, it has been taken to the values box. Let's bring it to our rows box by dragging it. Next, we don't want the months. So we uncheck the months, date and days, date here. Now it's starting to look something like a master sheet. But still in a typical pivot table format with all these items starting in the next line. Reminds me of step farming in the hills. Let's fix that. Right click anywhere in the pivot table and go to the pivot table options. Go to the display tab and choose classic pivot table layout. Hit OK. A little better. It's coming together but not quite. Let's get rid of these subtotals. Go to the design tab on the top and then to subtotals and choose do not show subtotals. Now it looks like a master sheet. Next step would be creating sheets for our clients. And if you recall, we need the company name in the report filter. But our company name is already in the values box. If we drag it to the report filter, it won't be present here. It's an easy fix. Let's go to a master sheet and insert a new column. Let's do that right next to the company name. You can leave it at its default name, which is column 1 in our case, or rename it accordingly. We are going to hide it anyways. Now, we are going to create a copy of the company name, but we can't copy and paste it here because then when we add records to this table, new names won't be copied. Instead, we are going to use a simple trick so every time something is added, this column automatically copies the company name from the original column. So, we do is equal to and select the company name column. Done. Did you notice how I wrote this in just one cell and it's copied to all the cells in the column? That's a neat feature of the tables. You should check out our video on tables if you wish to know about more benefits of using tables in your sheets. You'll find the link on the top right and in the description. Now, whenever any new record is added, this cell will copy the value in the company name cell. We can hide it now, its job is done. So right click here and select hide. Let's get back to our pivot table and right click. Select refresh and here we have our latest column. Let's drag this to our report filter box. If you had watched my previous video, by now you know where we are getting at. All we have to do is go to Pivot Table Analyze tab up here, click on this arrow in Options and choose Show Report Filter Pages. Then click OK on this dialog box and here we have our sheets. And just like the last time, Crestview Capital Management sheet name is not complete. You know, after doing the last video, I realized that I can edit it to the full name. There was no such limit of characters. So let's do that. Done. Also, due to the long name of the clients, it looks quite cluttered. Let's shorten our horizontal scroll bar so we have more space here. Much better. Let's bring our master sheet and the sheet with pivot table to the front. So select one of the sheets and then hold shift while selecting other. Then simply drag them to the front. Let's rename our pivot sheet to, well, pivot. Getting back to our client sheets, looks like we have to adjust the column width. Let's select the first one, hold shift and select the last one. Now all the sheets are selected. Let's select all the cells by clicking here and then double click like this and done. While we have got them selected, let's hide the filter up top as well. So right click here and choose hide. That's why the date column was so big. Let's fix that. You know what? Let's remove the pivot table fields as well. So whenever you show this to someone, they won't know right away that you've used pivot tables to create this marvel. But they can't be removed with multiple sheets selected. Thankfully though, we can remove it from just one sheet and all gets removed. Like this. If you want to see them again in some time in the future, go to Pivot Table Analyze tab and click here, Field List, and that'll bring them back up again. All done. Now let's recap where we're at. We've got all our client sheets with all the orders placed by them till date in their respective sheet. All have their separate sheet and that's half the job we set out to do. Next, and the important bit is to propagate the updates to the respective sheets as well. Let's work on that now. Let's create a new record in our master sheet, invoice number 197, date 30/9/2023. Let's copy this client, AquaGlow, with its location and paste it here. Let's put quantity as 3000. And I've got a VLOOKUP set up with my rate list up top here, so it gets the rate from there and rest are auto-calculated. Again, magic of using tables. So now we have got a new record. Let's check this. Let's get to AquaGlow sheet and of course it's not there. Because if you've used pivot tables, you know they don't get updated automatically. We have to refresh them. Like this. Now the record comes up. So whenever a new record is added, you have to go to the client sheet and click refresh. Nah, I'm just kidding. That's not the way to do it. What we want is whenever a new record is created, the client sheet gets updated automatically. And in the current scenario, it gets updated when we refresh the pivot table in it. So let's do something about that. Here comes the VBA bit and again, it's a teeny weeny bit. Let's right click on our master sheet and go to view code. And we'll get to the Microsoft Visual Basic window. Just like the last time, select worksheet from the first drop down. And unlike the last time, select change from the second drop down. You'll get to this bit. Select this part and delete it. Now in here, type active workbook dot refresh and you get all these suggestions. Choose refresh all by double clicking on it. That's all. We can close it now. Told you, it was just a teeny bit, didn't I? Now let's go and add a record. Let's add invoice number 198, date 01/10/2023. And this time, let's choose Alpine Peak Adventures. So copy the whole thing and paste it here. Let's choose the same item as before, so Ctrl D should do. And let's mention 4500 as quantity. Rest is calculated automatically and let's go and check the sheet of Alpine Peak. And here we have our new order. How cool is that? So we have checked adding records works like a charm. How about deleting a record? I think that should work too, right? Let's check that. And I'm not going to delete the new records that I created. I want to delete something that was present already. Let's see, invoice number 190 is for Data Pulse Technologies on September 20, 2023. Product is pencils and quantity is 5,557. Let's check if this order is present in our client's sheet. And there it is. Now let's delete it from the master sheet and see what happens. Select it by pressing Shift and Space Bar. And then to delete it, press Ctrl and Minus. Now let's check our client sheet, and as expected, it's deleted. So our system works both ways, and that's what we wanted. So job well done, right? That brings us to the end of this video. I personally believe that this method is easier than the advanced filter method. If you disagree, let me know in the comments. And if you have any other topic to see a video about, again, let me know in the comments. Rest is the usual: share, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, happy spreadsheeting.